You're probably already aware of a huge problem with the internet today, how most people are big tech peasants. What if I told you that some of us are participating in a peaceful peasants revolt, and you can too? Hey, I'm Wesley, and I make videos about Linux, free software, and related philosophies. In this video, I hope to give you a vision for a future where you are an internet landowner, rather than one of the many who are under the authoritarian rule of Google, Apple, Facebook, and the like. When the internet was in its infancy, websites were much more distributed, and information was spread across the few people who could actually host a website, such as universities or technologically capable individuals. Soon after, companies like MySpace invented platforms where you could kind of host your own site, even if you didn't know how to run a web server. This was eventually followed by companies like Facebook and Twitter. Search engines also were at one time more abundant, though they are increasing in number again in the last 5 years or so. But now the dominant player in search also creates computers, phones, watches, and even provides cloud storage services. That's one company. Eventually, everyone started to realize that by gathering under these central companies within the internet, that meant that there was now basically a king who could also make laws and enforce them by putting offenders in jail, excommunicating them, or placing them in the stocks. Often, kingdoms start because there was some good king who allowed his citizens to prosper abundantly. That was the case in all of the FANG companies. But like all kingdoms, subsequent kings sometimes are good and sometimes are bad. Without any underlying guiding principles, the rules of the kingdom are determined by whims of the king. That seems to be the case with big tech. The question we really need to ask now is, what guiding principles do Google, Facebook, and the like live by? They aren't necessarily shaped by the majority opinion, so what does shape them? Are they just like old-fashioned kings? Do they just want money, power, and women? Further, who gets to choose what the guiding principle is for the company? If the answer is each person on the content team, then we have a real problem on our hands, because one guy thinks the guiding principle is what makes the most money. Another thinks the guiding principle is whatever the majority of users want. Another thinks it's whatever the Buddha says. These are not compatible with each other. So what we end up with is a bunch of companies flopping around with the clumsy guiding principles based on political and cultural news cycles of Silicon Valley rich folks. And that is a very unreliable entity to depend on for ensuring your personal values aren't going to be considered deplorable in these internet kingdoms. Although we signed a sort of contract with big tech when we accepted the terms of service and became subjects of their kingdom, they haven't upheld the freedoms due to individuals and organizations that utilize their platforms. I propose an alternative political order. We should declare independence. We should place the responsibility of software services on ourselves and provide those services to the community we're already a part of, wherever that's possible. That may be our families, friends, churches, civic clubs, etc. Here's a practical example. Your family needs a repository of old family photos or videos that you took from the 90s. Instead of making everyone use an Apple device, or making everybody use Google Photos, set up your own server. Another example, maybe your church needs a shared calendar to post on the website. Host it yourself on a freedom-respecting alternative. So how could you get started doing something like this? Well, I'd recommend starting where I started, a service that doesn't necessarily require constant uptime, such as a cloud storage service. And there are several freedom-respecting alternatives out there. The one I use is called Nextcloud. Nextcloud is a server-side software suite that kind of provides similar services to the Google suite. It provides file storage services like Google Drive, calendar and contact management, a cloud-based office suite with Word document and spreadsheet or editors, and call, chat, and video conferencing. If you're watching this, you're probably the family's tech guy. That means, with a little research, you're probably totally capable of managing these sorts of services yourself. Now, there are definitely a set of challenges involved when hosting your own software, such as the need to think about security, availability, and backups. But such is the life of a landowner. When you own property, you've got to take care of it. But that also means you have complete control, unquestionable privacy, and no concern that your crazy religious beliefs are going to be considered abominable next week. And it's not like you can never go back to the kingdoms of Fang to visit. But once you're a landowner, you don't really want to. The air over here smells fresh and free and empowering. Here's a quote from Noah Webster. He was examining the guiding principles of the U.S. Constitution. Let the people have property, and they will have power. A power that will forever be exerted to prevent a restriction of the press, an abolition of trial by jury, or the abridgment of any other privilege. See you next time.